Mas os planos de cooperativa formam por party. What is the reason to make this cooperative formal? And why we are making the cooperative formal? In past earlier days, we go in the history of the Indian. There is a cooperative forming by the landlords and by the kings. They are making the in the recent in 19th century it has been banished. Cooperative forming has been banished because the jamindars they are doing own their individual farmings. And now recently why we don't make again the cooperative forming is that we are facing the main thing is the labor problem, the electricity, and the marketing, the middlemen. For that reason, now again we want to make the recycle of the everything. So my plan is to make the cooperative forming in the rural areas. The need of this major thing is stop exploitation of the farmer from the marginal middlemen. For example, rice mill owners and the same interest because the farmers who are going to make this, they are in nowadays in villages we are going to mix, they are very small farmers like 1 acre, 2 acre, and they are hiring interest from the landlords or landowners who are having high monies and they are has to pay heavy interest for them. And the paddy cooperative in this, the economic scale is better crop. Paddy is the better crop for nowadays. In last 4 to 5 years back it was a weak because the reason is that the paddy has been, the rate of the paddies has been weak. After these 5 years, the paddy rate has been stable in the state level because the government has given the minimum rates for the paddy. And we can create the brand. My idea is from the starting position of the paddy, it means from the growth stage till the packing. So how we can do this? The various steps is there, what are good? The reason is that my, for example, from the starting positions, the farmer only comes until the position of selling rice to the rice mill owners, that's all. In the future, these steps are not going to take in the next steps, for example, rice mill owners. And from rice mill owners, they are making different steps in rices, for example, rice fillets in different areas. What are going to do? Then the farmers are getting only until the middlemen. The middlemen are purchasing the paddies. And then next, they are not getting the profits. So my idea is to get profit for all that. For example, in cooperative farming, we make that thing possibly means we can get profit in rice and we can get branding to sell because we can see the packed rice in same shop, in malls only. The open rice is for 50 rupees and the packed rice is for 70 to 90 rupees. So my idea is to make that one. For micro environment is variation of price in paddies nowadays and rainfall because if this is the major thing in the rainfall is that if it is less, it's also weak. If it is high, it's also not possible. And the stable rainfall. And the major thing is the pest. We have to control the pest and the world economy. What are we seeing the world economy? Because most of the, in 1970, the Norman Borlaug is the best example for this paddy growing. He has been varieties of paddies. And world economy is suitable for this paddy also because the paddy, if we are going to export the paddy, it depends upon the world ratios, world price. And the micro environment is we want good quality of the seeds to go, for example, I told in Borlaug has been invented varieties of the seeds. And the labor, we want the labor and weed pest controls and electricity. We know that all in the rural areas, the electricity only 6 hours per day, that is not satisfied, that is the micro environment. And market feasibility, because the market feasibility is this, the staple food of South India is majorly rice. And in China, South Asia, most of the South Asians is rice. And we are selling for the rice mill owners and the seeds for example, we are selling the rices for the rice mills and seeds for the Monsanto and the Progro companies. They are making the seeds generation and genetically they are converting into high quality seeds and they are selling. And technical feasibility. What is the technical feasibility is that for now present we are making the pollet project for a small project for nearly 100 acres because the reason is that we cannot go immediately for many cooperative farming for 1000 acres, for 2000 acres. For the reason is that small project for 100 acres, the minimum. And the terms and agreements we are making, hiring the farmers to make this farm. And it means and machineries for the equipment and stable agriculture techniques. For example, BSc AG Agri and MSc AG Agri to take some guidance from them. And the financial varieties. The most first, for example, we're making the paddy for 1 acre. This is for 1 acre. And the what is the expenses is going for the 1 acre? For we need 20 kgs of seeds for 1 acre. It costs about 800 rupees. It means a high quality seeds, and for 200 rupees for labors nowadays. And the cultivation we need before we have to sowing the seeds. We need to cultivation. It costs about 3000 rupees, and for sowing the paddies, 2000 rupees overall net. 5,000 rupees, and the interest we are going to place this is that 7% as per the government bank rates for the farmers. Because if we go for the landlords, we are purchasing finance from the others, we have to pay nearly 25-30% of the interest. This is the interest for us, the bank purpose. And the total cost is 5,030 rupees for first month we are expending. And the second month, second 20 days in paddy, we are expensing for every 20 days. And for first fertilizing 2 bags for it costs 100,000 rupees, and it's 2,000 rupees labor to fertilizing the it's for 200 rupees for term, and liquid fertilizer 1 liter of fertilizing liquid fertilizer cost of dividing. It's main is reason for dividing is very necessary in paddy. Dividing is the most thing, and it is for 1,000 rupees total. It is 4,400 rupees, and present for 20 days interest is 18 rupees, and the past interest is 20 rupees. And overall it's then 4,438. And this the second for same as for second 20 days. This is for third. This is the 3 steps we are going to incur the financially. And the final we are making the harvesting for 1 acre is 2,500 rupees. For gaining and packaging is 500 rupees. Total expense is 3,000 rupees. And this is for 1 acre overall expenses. The total expenses is 29,000 rupees for 1 acre of the paddy. This is for 100 acre our pilot project is what is going to be. And the cost of the present price for 40 kg for 40 bags we get it from 1 acre, it's 75 kg per bag. The price for per bag is 1100 rupees. Total we get 44,000. The expense plus interest is 29,000. We are getting 15,000 as a profit. The net profit is 35,000. My thing is that in cooperative farming, if we go for future, it means in rice milling and in corn flakes, whatever make the flakes, we can get more than this 35%, more than 50-60% we can get. And this is directly going to the farmers. There is no middleman. And the limitations. The major limitations is cash consideration in the rural areas. This is the major problem in the rural areas and the middlemen and the rice mill cartels. Thank you.